So you've just bolted on stuff together, you made the world, walked around a bit, and then you died to a spider on anabolic steroids. That happens. Don't worry, I'm here to help you with that. This guide on how to get started out is the first part of a 7 video series which will teach you all the stuff that you need to know to actually be able to survive. Before you can even do anything, you have to create a new world. Here you can set your name, and you should probably set this to solo so that someone won't just randomly join and start putting your world down. When you go to world settings, the game lets you change pretty much anything and you can play around with it, but I recommend you keep most of the things as they are because they're fine that way. Although here are some things you might want to consider changing. Wildfires can be a pain in the ass during summer, so you can turn these down if you struggle with them. Same with hound attacks, where you might want to turn down the frequency. The one thing I really do recommend turning down is poison birch nut trees. You probably have no idea what they are right now, and be glad you don't, because they're just fucking evil. When you go over to world generation, I recommend you change the world size to either small or medium, because depending on how fast you are, even a small world can take up to 10 days to explore, which is literally half of autumn. Starting resource variety decides if certain resources will be replaced with an alternative source, such as that grass tufts will be replaced with grass geckos, or saplings will be replaced by twigged trees. Classic means they're all the default source, highly random means several will be replaced, and default is somewhere in between. I usually set this to classic so that it's consistent. Also, you might want to change the settings for caves, but I usually just make them small and leave all the other settings as they are. Now for mods, these are the mods I'm using. They're mostly quality of life. I will make a modding guide as the last part of the series, so if you want to see that, if you're watching the video when it's uploaded, you'll have to wait a bit. Now that all your settings are set, you can now create the world. Before you spawn in, you have to pick your character. I highly recommend picking Wilson, because he's the default character that all the other characters are based off of, and he has no real downsides, and he also grows a beard, which can help you a lot during winter. You might also want to consider Wolfgang, who has the ability to do double damage depending on his mightiness status, but he does consume a lot more food. Another option is Wendy, who has a personal bodyguard which can be pretty powerful, especially when dealing with a lot of smaller creatures, but she does deal less damage than normal. And you should also not play Wes, he's just suicide. A fellow non-straw YouTuber plays as him because he's trying to compensate for his ridiculous Asian accent, but don't take his advice, don't play as Wes, don't be stupid. When you spawn in, the first thing you see is obviously the world, and then your user interface. On the top right, you can see your hunger, health and sanity, and also the day and night cycle. On the bottom of the screen, you can see your inventory, and on the right part of your inventory, you can see the item you're holding, a body item, and a head item you're wearing. On the left side of your screen, you can see the crafting menu, and below it are some shortcut items, which there's probably not gonna be any. When you click on the crafting menu itself, it opens, and yeah, it's a crafting menu. You probably know what a crafting menu is. If you have the combined status mod, your hunger, health, and sanity will always show the number you're at without you having to hover on them, and you also see the season cycle. This is probably the most important part, as these are the most common causes of early game deaths. So let's get into them. The first danger you're probably gonna encounter is the night, more specifically the dark. When it turns night, it's pitch black. If you are in the dark and you're not holding or are near a low source of light, you're gonna die to someone called Charlie. For the first few nights, you're gonna be deciding between a torch and a campfire. You can find them both in the light sources category of the crafting menu, and that's how every item is categorized, such as that you can find in chests and storage solutions. And if you can't find something by category, just type the name in the search bar. The torch is an equipable item, which means you can be moving and exploring the world while it's dark, which is what makes it the option you should use the most. The other good option is a campfire, which you have to place down so it looks in place, but you can use it when you're fighting something or chopping wood or whatever, and you can also cook food on it. The forest slowly runs out as time goes on, and adding flammable items such as logs or grass will make it bigger, and when the fire runs out, the campfire gets destroyed. A more refined replacement for the torch is a lantern, which requires a light bulb, so you'll need to go to the caves, and you need to be near an alchemy engine to craft it, which makes it not very accessible from the beginning. Just like the torch, it loses durability when you use it, but you can refill that durability with light bulbs, so it's a lot less resource hungry in the long run. When it's a full moon, which happens every 20 days starting on day 11. It's not dark during the night, so you don't need a light source. Jesus Christ, this is so long. Next up is hunger. When you at least kind of know what you're doing, hunger isn't really much of an issue. Basically, in the first 5 to 10 days, all you really need to do is pick berries, pick carrots, and kill butterflies. Butterflies give 9 hunger, but more importantly, they heal you by 8 health, which is huge at this stage of the game. You can kill one by getting right on top of it, and then you press Control F. Control F attacks any nearest creature that isn't considered friendly. You might also get the occasional hunt, which is when you find these suspicious fruit piles. When you investigate it, it shows the footprint of a paw. If you go in this direction, about a screen away you will find another suspicious truth pile, and when you follow that, it leads you to another one, and so on. After 6 to 12 truth piles, you'll get to the end, which is where you can find the animal. It's usually a koalaphant, but it can be a varg or an eucus, however you pronounce that. If you get one of those two, it's best to leave them where they are, and don't go to that area of the map until you're prepared, because they're both really dangerous. If it's a koalaphant, you'll have to chase it towards the edge of the map where you can try to get it stuck. Then you can hit it once and immediately lodge, and after that, just hit it 6 times and repeat that. You can also wait for night when it falls asleep and attack it then. The third thing is insanity. Now, it might seem really scary when you're starting out, and all of a sudden, your own mind turns on you and starts sending Matrix agents to kill you.
The Matrix has attacked you.
First of all, they're pretty easy to kill. The crawling horror is the first type. You can just bait out an attack and then hit it. It'll teleport by a bit, and then you repeat it. Bait, hit, etc. If you're fast enough, you can also hit it before you bait out an attack, but that's a little risky. The other one is a Terrorbeak, and it's basically just the crawling horror, but it's a lot faster and more dangerous. The strategy to kill it is the exact same. After you hit any nightmare creature, keep swinging in case it teleports right on top of you. You can also control your sanity. It already goes up whenever you kill a shadow creature, and here are some other ways you can increase it. Picking flowers increases your sanity by 5 each. Prototyping an item or learning a recipe from a blueprint increases it by 15. Eating cooked cactus also increases it by 15. And wearing a top hat increases it by 3.33 sanity a minute. There is a really big amount of things that can affect your sanity, positively or negatively, and I'm not going to go over all of them now. But these are some of the easiest and most common ways to increase it. Last threat are monsters or hostile creatures. To kill 90% of all hostile creatures, the strategy is to hit them a certain amount of times, dodge, and just repeat that. If you can just learn the amount of hits you can do before having to dodge, you'll be good. You should also be wearing armor, which will usually be the football helmet, as it takes up the head slot. The reason for this is that if you get hit, even once, without armor, you will lose a lot of health. For example, spiders, which are some of the weakest creatures in the game, they deal 15 damage, and without armor, you'd take more damage than if you get hit by deer claws from wearing a football helmet, from which you'll take 15 damage. And kind of a bonus danger is seasons. The first dangerous season is winter, and you have 20 days to prepare for it. Last time, I made you guys for all 4 seasons, so you can watch those. Now that you know the basics of what does what and how to not see people die, now you have to still do the correct things. First of all, make sure to collect grass and twigs, and try to get a full stack of each, which is 40. Flint is also quite useful in case you need to make tools, but at this start of the stage, you don't really even have to do that. Your goal at the start of the game is to explore the edges of the world so that you know where all the important things are. Exciting, I know. I usually ignore everything and make my priority just exploring the world as quickly as possible so that I have as much time as possible when I'm done exploring. Now, what should you look for? The British biome, which is picking wolf deserts. They're both useful and they're a little different from each other in terms of the stuff you can get from them. The swamp, which is the most hostile biome, but it has useful resources. The savanna, but the one that has beefles. You should make your base in between these important points of interest so that neither of them are too far away, and also make your base somewhat close to a cave entrance. Don't make your base right next to it, because during dusk and night, weird bird things will come out of it and they'll attack you, and they do when they're pretty far from the hole, so you should make your base about 2 screens away from it. These were all of the very basic important things to know about when starting out. As I said before, this is the first of 7 videos that explore all the basics of the game, and the next video will be on what to do before winter comes. Goodbye!